In continuation to our previous lecture, today we are going to discuss some more part related to the linear algebra, which includes linear span, linear independence, basis and dimensions. Before starting the today's lecture, we have to recall some basic definitions of vector space and vector subspaces. According to the real vector space, we have a non-empty set V with two algebraic operations, addition and multiplication, that is satisfies the following conditions. Under the operation addition, the elements of vector V must satisfy these four conditions, which includes additive identity and additive inverse also. Under the operation called scalar multiplication, the elements of V must satisfy the following four conditions, including the multiplicative identities. The elements of vector space are called vectors. According to the definition of vector subspaces, if W be a non-empty subset of a vector space V, then W is called a vector subspace of V if W is a vector space under the operations defined in V. In order to show a vector subspace, there is no need to verify all the rules defined with vector space. It is enough to check that 0 belongs to W, addition of two vector belongs to again in W, and scalar product with vector also belongs in W. The other rules are satisfied accordingly. After having the basic idea about the vector space and vector subspaces, in this lecture, we define and explain the basic concepts of linear span, linear independence of vector, basis and dimensions. To understand the concept of linear span, we shall consider these two examples. Take a vector 1, 1 belongs to the two-dimensional real space and consider a set of the elements type alpha product with 1, 1, where alpha is any real number. Obviously, this is a straight line passing through the origin. Hence, it is a subspace of two-dimensional real space. In three-dimensional real space, if we consider another set which contains the elements of the type alpha 1, 1, 4 plus beta multiplied with a vector 2, 1, 3, where alpha and beta are real numbers. Obviously, this set represents a plane passing through the origin, and this is also a subspace of R3. In these two examples, we have seen that one or two elements generate subspaces. We will define the concept of linear span formally below. Let S be any set containing the elements u1, u2, un be a subspace of vector space V, then the linear span of S is the set denoted by span S or L of S and defined by the following set. If S is empty, we define linear span of S containing only single element, that is 0. The combination alpha 1 u1 plus alpha 2 u2 and so on up to alpha n un is called linear combination of uis. To understand the concept, we consider one example. Is a vector 4, 5, 5 is linear combination of these three vectors? Then solution is yes. There exist alpha, beta and gamma such that alpha multiplied with first vector plus beta multiplied with second vector plus gamma multiplied with third vector is equal to the given vector 4, 5, 5. After solving the system of linear equations, one can easily get the values of alpha, beta and gamma. In fact, these values are 3, minus 1 and 0, which represents that the vector 4, 5, 5 is a linear combination of the other three vectors. This is an important property related to the linear span. which we have to remember for further problems. Let S be any non-empty subset of a vector space V, then linear span of S is a subspace of V. In fact, it is the smallest subspace of V containing S. Let V be a vector space, then a finite set V1, V2, Vn of elements of V is said to be linear dependent if there exist scalars alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha n not all zero, such that alpha 1 V1 plus alpha 2 V2 and so on up to alpha n Vn equal to 0. If the above relation is satisfied only for alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha n all are 0, then the set of vector is said to be linearly independent. We can understand the concept by this example. Consider a set of vectors 2, 0, 0, 3, 1, 0, and 5, 6, 4. We have to check whether this this set of vectors is linearly dependent or independent. We consider these vectors as V1, V2 and V3. According to the definition, we know that if none of these vector can be expressed as a linear combination of other two, then the vectors are independent. Otherwise, they are dependent. So if we consider V is a linear combination of V1 and V2, then there would exist scalars alpha 1, alpha 2, such that alpha 1 V1 plus alpha 2 V2 equal to V3. This equation reduces to alpha 1 multiplied with 2, 0, 0 and alpha 2 product with 3, 1, 0 is equal to 5, 6, 4, which is equivalent to the set of equations 2 alpha 1 plus 2 alpha 2 equal to 5, alpha 2 equal to 6 and 0 equal to 4, which is not possible. So, however, this is an inconsistent system, so none of these vectors can be expressed as a linear combination of the other two. Hence, the vectors are linearly independent. Following the similar pattern of the problem considered previously, one can easily show that the set of vectors given in this example is linearly dependent, and another example are linearly dependent. These are some basic properties which we have to learn for the concept of linear independence of vectors. Let V be a vector space and S is any subset of V. If S is linearly independent, then 0 does not belong to the set S. Let V be a vector space and S is any subset of V. If S is linearly independent, then every non-empty subset of S is also linearly independent. Let V be a vector space and S is a subset of V. If S is linearly dependent, then every set containing S is also linearly dependent. Now we start the another concept which is also associated with the linear algebra, that is basis. Basis is a combination of the two concepts, linearly independent and spanning set. So according to the definition, a subset B containing the elements U1, U2, UN is a basis of a vector space V if B is linearly independent and span of B is V. We consider some examples related to the basis. The set E1, 1, 0, 0, E2, 0, 1, 0, E3, 0, 0, 1 is a basis of V. The basis E1, E2, E3 is called standard basis of R3. The another set 1, 1, 0, 0, -1, 1, and 1 comma 0 comma 1 is linearly dependent, so it does not satisfy the definition of basis. Hence it is not a basis of R3. The set 1 comma 1 comma 1 comma 1 comma 1 comma 0 and 1 comma 0 comma 0 is again a basis of R3, as this satisfies the conditions of basis. The another example of basis is the set 1 comma x comma x square. It is also a basis of R3. The set 1 comma 1 comma 1 and 1 comma 1 comma 0 and 1 comma 0 comma 0 is also a basis of P3, the set of all polynomials of degree less and equal to 2. If V1, V2, Vn is a basis of V, then any V belongs to V is a unique linear combination of V1, V2 and Vn. These are some standard bases and most popular vector spaces. In R2, I given by 1 comma 0 and J 0 comma 1 is known as standard basis. Further, in R3, the bases are given by I, J and K. In case of nth dimensional space, the vectors are E1, E2, En, known as standard basis. For the set of polynomials of degree n, which is denoted by Pn, is again a standard basis containing these elements 1, x, x square and xn. In M22, that is all matrices with all entries 0 except for one entry, which is 1. There are four such type of matrices. They are known as standard basis of that. Again, in case of MMN, all the matrices with all entries 0 except for one entry, which is 1, they are M into N such matrices. Dimension. So, to know the concept of dimension, we consider the following note. We often say that R1 is one dimension, R2 is two dimension, and R3 is three dimension. Note that the set containing element 1 is a basis of R1. E1 and E2 given by 1 comma 0 and 0 comma 1 respectively is a basis for R2, and the another set E1, E2, E3 is a basis of R3. Similarly, EI given by this set is a basis of Rn, which is called n dimensional space. We see that the concept of dimension is related to the number of elements in a basis. For example, counting the elements of the standard basis of each of the popular vector spaces, we have that dimension of nth dimensional space is n, dimension of Pn is n plus 1, and dimension of MMn is m into n. Now we know how we can get the null space, row space and column space of a matrix. If we consider a matrix A of order m cross n, then we define the column space of A is equal to the subspace of Rn spanned by the columns of A. Its dimension is called rank of the matrix A. The row space of A is equal to the subspace of Rn spanned by the rows of A. The null space of A, which is equal to the solution space of Ax equal to 0. It is a subspace of Rn. Its dimension is called nullity of the matrix A. This is very important theorem related to the rank and nullity of a matrix. Let A be any matrix having order m cross n, then rank of matrix A plus nullity of matrix A is always equal to n. Dimension column space of A is equal to dimension row space of A is equal to rank of A equal to number of leading ones in the reduced row echelon form of matrix A. So to understand the concept of reduced row echelon form, we have the following points. Let A be an matrix of order m cross n, then reduce the matrix A to the reduced row echelon form. Dimension of column space of A is equal to dimension of row space of A is equal to rank of A, number of leading ones in the RREF of matrix A. The same basis for the solution space of Rx equal to 0 is the basis of the null space of A. Consider the non-zero rows of R. They form a basis for the row space of R. The same basis of the row space of R is a basis for the row space of R. Take the columns of R with leading ones. They form a basis of the column space of R. The corresponding column vectors in A form a basis for the column space of A. Some important properties of the form RREF. If a row does not have only zeros, then its first non-zero number is a 1. We call this a leading one. The row that contain only zeros, if there are any, are at the bottom of the matrix. In any consecutive rows that do not have only zeros, the leading one in the row is further right than the leading one in the row above. Each column that contain a leading one has zeros everywhere else in that column. So the dimension of a vector space may be finite or infinite. So according to the definition, a vector space V is said to be finite dimensional if there exists a basis containing of finite number of elements. Otherwise, V is called infinite dimensional. The dimension of a finite dimensional vector space V, denoted by dim of V, is the number of elements in a basis of V. These are some basic properties of finite dimensional vector spaces. Let V be a finite dimensional vector spaces, then any two bases of V have the same number of elements. Let dimension of a vector V is n, then any linearly independent set of n vectors of V is a basis of V. We understand the concept of basis by this example. Let S be any set containing the vectors of the type x1, x2, x3, x4 given in this example, be a subset of fourth dimensional space, then find a basis of LS. Consider the matrix A and apply the row transformations to obtain A equal to this one. So initially we have simply rearranged the vectors given in the problem. After applying the row transformation, the vector may be written like this. After further calculation, the vector, the matrix A may be written in this form. Therefore, rank of A is 3. Obviously, the fourth row containing all zero elements. So only there are 3 non-zero rows. So rank of A is 3. Hence, here 3 vectors are linearly independent and they also span S, because each vector xi can be represented as a linear combination of 3 non-zero vectors of V. Therefore, the set 1, 1, 1, 0, -2, 0, 0, and 0, 0, -1, 0 is a basis of LS. These vectors are obtained from the reduced row echelon form given above. Similarly, if we consider another example, let S be any set containing 3 vectors x1, x2 and x3, then find a basis of linear span S and extend it to a basis of R. Following the similar manner, if we reduce our matrix by applying the row transformations, if we reduce our matrix in another form, then we get A in this form. Therefore, rank of A is 3 and the set this is a basis of LS. To extend it to a basis of R4, we need a vector of the form 0, 0, 0, T, where T is not equal to 0. For example, if we consider a vector 0, 0, 0, 1 to this set, here note that this vector also belongs to the R4. Hence, the set containing the three vectors defined above and another one is 0, 0, 0, 1 is linearly independent. As the dimension of this R4 is 0, so the set becomes a basis of fourth dimensional space R4. Thank you.